Hello everyone, it's Nina. Thanks so much for joining me today. I'm excited to be bringing you a project featuring the new Simon Says stamp Send Happiness release. This new collection has so many amazing products in it, and I'm going to be using the Fairy Tale Spinners stamp and die set to create a spinner card. Spinner cards are a unique interactive design that allow you to suspend an image in the middle of a window scene with a piece of string. When you twist the image around a few times and then let it go, the image will spin. And this is a really simple and easy card to make, so I'm going to show you how I did it. I started off by taking the Fairy Tale Spinners stamp set, and I'm stamping the front and back of one of the fairy images here, because these two images are going to be sandwiching the piece of string that's going to allow these two images to spin. Spinner cards work best when you have an image that has a front and a back. Now, if you don't have an image that is a front and back, you could always use a symmetrical shape to stamp an image twice and then sandwich those symmetrical shapes together between some string. So I stamped not only the fairies, but also a bunch of floral elements from the Fairy Tale Spinners stamp set. Now I colored all of these images with Copic markers, and I colored them very simply. So I'm going to kind of speed through the coloring here and skip over some spots because I really want to show you how to build this spinner card. And I figured you could color the images however you want. So you'll notice I used a variety of bright, happy colors. The fairy has some beautiful blue wings and a pink dress. And I also colored all of the flowers with some purples, pinks, yellows, and even a little bit of teal. The images are colored and then die cut, and I'm ready to work on building my spinner. So the first thing I need to do is create the window, and that is going to be created with a Simon Says stamp circle die. I cut this from a panel, and this will eventually get layered onto my A2 card base. I put a piece of strong double-sided tape on the back side of my circle window, and I stretched a piece of string across those pieces of tape. Then I took one of my fairies, which has adhesive on it, and laid it onto the string that's suspended between the window. Now you can't see the string because it's super, super thin, so it's very hard to see on camera. But that string is there, and after I placed the first fairy down over top of the string, I then laid the other fairy over top of the backside of the first fairy that I laid down. I set that aside and I'm moving on to creating a little scene behind the window that my fairy is going to be suspended in front of. The window that I cut out left, of course, a negative circle, so I'm using that as the window scene. I ink blended a beautiful background with some distress oxide inks, and I'm going to decorate it with the floral elements that I had cut and colored from the Fairy Tale Spinners stamp set. This little circle scene will go into the inside of my A2 card. You'll be able to see this visibly through the window that my fairy is suspended in. In front of the window that my fairy is suspended from, I'm adding a piece of the grass along the bottom portion just for a little bit of depth. And I used two layers of foam tape to pop that up so that way it didn't hinder the little spinner effect. So when you have a spinner card, you'll want to go ahead and spin the fairy around many times or whatever image you're creating a spinner card with. And then once you let go, the fairy spins around and it's so cute. I love this effect. It's such a cool way to add a fun interactive element to your card. Now that I have my scene built, I'm going to lay this down onto my A2 card base, which also has that same circle window cut from it. This is so that way we can see right through to the inside of the card, which of course has that circle scene that we were building adhered down into the middle of the card. Now that we have all of our scene and our fairy tale spinner put together, we're ready to add a few more details. I not only embellished the card with a few butterflies from the stamp set, but I also stamped a couple of greetings from the set onto the inside of the card, and also I white heat embossed a sentiment that I'll attach down onto the front of the card. The next thing I did was I took one of the little star stamps that's in the stamp set, and I'm going to stamp them onto the background using some Delicata silver ink. This is a really nice pigment ink, and since oxide ink blending is completely dry at this point, it really lets that beautiful silver color shine nicely. To add a few more stars, I used a white gel pen, and that adds a really nice pop of contrast too. to finish things up, I always have to add a little bit of sparkle somewhere, so I decided to apply a bit of glossy accent down onto the wings of my fairy, and I pulled out the Lawn Fawn Prisma Glitter. This is the really nice fine glitter, and I added that over top of her wings, and that creates a really beautiful shimmery effect. This magical little scene was so much fun to create. I really love how this fairy spins around in her sweet little scene, and when you open up the card, you get this beautiful night sky and a really nice, beautiful sentiment shining back at you. I hope that you enjoyed today's card featuring the Fairy Tale Spinners stamp and die set from Simon Says Stamp, which is from their new Send Happiness collection. If you enjoyed today's video, I hope you'll stop by my blog to get more information not only on today's project, but also on the entire new release from Simon Says Stamp. Thanks so much for tuning in today. I'll be back again very soon with more to share. And until next time, I hope you have a wonderful day. Bye!